now we're so very hungry and thirsty. That's why we're here, because even it's so, if you have water or food there, maybe you can give us.
November 8, 2013, around 8 a.m., the super typhoon Haiyan, locally known as Yolanda, shocked the whole world with her clash when she had the landfall in the province of Leyte, hitting strongly the capital of Tacloban. Many people have been saved from the strong wind, but sadly, never from the storm surge. With powerful waves sweeping the islands, thousands of victims drowned in the sea. Initially, it was reported that almost 10,000 people were either missing or dead. According to UN officials, about 11 million people have been affected and many have been left homeless. The challenge of what to do with the dead is one thing, but how to help those who have survived traumatically is equally of great concern. We had the opportunity to see the aftermath of the tragic situation in the city of Tacloban. Along with it, we expressed a desire to support and encourage the pastors and the Christian brethren who were unfortunately hit by the super typhoon Haiyan or Yolanda.
Ako po si Edwin Espina. Ako ay pastor dito sa Tacloban Bible Community. In fact, marami nang dumating na bagyo. Number 4 din kami, nawala ng kuryente, lahat. Pero ito, ang bagyo na ito na Yolanda ay talagang napakalupit at napaka-destructive. It destroyed not only properties, but it destroyed lives. And some other typhoons that hit our place, medyo minimal lang yung mga patay, but dito ay thousands ang namatay dito. It was good that the government has declared martial law in this place. Kailangan talaga. Now for a few days, mayroon kami naririnig na mga putok ng baril. Yung mga putok ng baril ay dahil nandoon may maraming mga magnanakaw na nagbabarge in, niraransak yung mga bahay-bahay. Yung mga biktima ay pwede rin maging victor. Na hindi lang tayo magstay as victims, but rather, we would overcome our situation from being a victim to be a victor so that we can be of help to other people. Yung mga pastor na umalis din, I understand their feelings. Maybe, yun lang talaga ang naisip nila. I'm not going to be afraid of this, how this, the strong the typhoon was, the destruction. I can rely so much on the strength. I can rely so much on the power of the Lord, because He is over and above the calamities.
The strongest typhoon so far to hit the country of the Philippines has brought not only a challenge to the area of Leyte, but even in the entire nation. It brought a global assistance to the people who have been severely affected by the super typhoon. But the rebuilding will take time to see the nation rise once again in the great calamity the nation of the Philippines has ever experienced. The heart of Build a Tent Church project is to restructure one of the most important institutions which Typhoon Haiyan did not spare with its wild hit in Leyte, which is the church. We believe that in difficult times like this, building churches is of utmost importance as victims of the typhoon are recovering from deep emotional trauma, fears of the future, and a very low morale. We believe the significant role of the church is to uplift, strengthen, and encourage the people to believe in God once again. One tent church costs approximately 150,000 pesos for a 100 seating capacity and 300,000 pesos for a 200 seating capacity. We will also be helping 4 churches to rebuild their roofs, which costs about 150,000 pesos each. This crisis made us stronger than ever. We have witnessed unimaginable comfort, support, and sympathy from all over the country and all over the world. And how can we miss this opportunity to help rebuild and restore their lives through Christian churches?